Hello, I'm Neeraj. Today I will try to explain the graph neural network architecture. This is the first part of this tutorial. In the second part, I will try to explain the graph convolutional neural network architecture. And in the third part, I will try to explain the text-based graph neural network architecture. So let us try to understand the first part, graph neural network architecture. The first and important thing that we should consider is why we need the graph neural network architecture. What are the merits and demerits of the traditional deep neural network architectures? So, if you go through the traditional neural network architecture, for example, suppose how to handle the image data, then you will realize that first of all, we convert the image pixels into grid, and this is called grid representation. The grid representations may be binary grid representations, or we can use some numerical values with grid representations. Once we convert the image data, image pixel data into the grid representations, it becomes, or nature of the data that you can imagine is static. So static nature of the data is one of the important feature once we convert the image into the image pixels into the grid representation. After that, it is very easy to apply the CNN, or we can say that stacks of convolution and poolings. Now let us try to understand the traditional data. The traditional data may be univariate or time or multivariate time series data. We can easily store the univariate time series data through array, and multivariate time series data through matrix. Similarly, we can use the multi-feature data through matrix, and we can directly use or apply it through any of the deep neural network architecture. Here also, you can consider we are getting the same important thing, nature and representation of the data is static. Now come to the text. Suppose we have a text of total vocabulary size k words, and we have to pass the text through some LSTM blocks. Then we generally pass the words with the embeddings also. We generally use word to break or glove embedding or fast text embedding with any dimensions like 100 or 300 or like that. This converts your data into a matrix with k number of columns, and suppose you are using 300 dimensions of embedding, then again it is in the form of matrix, and again the representation, the major feature of this representation is it is static. Now try to understand that what will happen if we use or try to feed the graph based data into the similar kind of deep learning architectures. Then what will happen? Suppose we have a graph with 6 nodes. The most easiest representation of this graph is adjacency matrix. But the major problem is we cannot directly apply this adjacency matrix effectively with any of these neural network arrangements. Let us try to understand what type of problem we will face if we convert the graph into a static kind of adjacency matrix, compute the features or extract the features of each of those nodes, and then pass it through some deep neural network architecture. Here we have used the ordered numbering of nodes A, B, C, D, E, F, like that, like A, B, C, D, E, F. And then we try to understand that what are the connected nodes or edges. Then we say that there are edges between A and B, A and B, A and C. So A and B we use one, A and C we use one, A and D we use one. And for the rest of them, we use the number 0. Similarly, we have identified the connected edges for B. Only two edges are there with A and C. So here we use the 1 and rest of them are 0. Now we have some features also. For node A, we have features 1, 1, 1, 3 features F0, F1 and F2. Similarly, for node B, we have three features 1, 1 and 0. So, for all nodes, we have some features. Now, what will be the problem if we pass those features directly through any of those kinds of neural network architecture, like deep neural network architecture, CNN or LSTM kind of architectures? The major problem is ordering of node. Because all the features are associated with the node orders. So if we change the way to capture the nodes, the entire arrangements and even the entire relations, between those nodes in the matrix will change and it will give entirely different result. So, and even it is very tough to manage those orders. The next point is, suppose we add or delete some node, like suppose we add a node G with link here, like that. Now it will totally change the entire adjacency matrix and feature representation. And due to those changes, the things that we learned earlier will be useless. So addition or deletion of any node in the current static arrangement will highly affect the computations. And several times, suppose you have some system with some features and you train it, then its components, trained component, will not be useful and you require a complete retraining from scratch. And you have to manage the again reorder, again manage the orders of the same thing. So you need to develop some mechanism to maintain the order also, to manage those features also. And again, if you want to see the connectivity, how those nodes are connected, you have to update the matrix also. This all creates a lot of issues. That's why we are not using adjacency matrix based arrangement with features with any of those static kind of network arrangements to train the deep learning architecture for graph. So what may be the suitable architecture to train such kind of deep learning, to train such kind of graph based architecture? For that, we need to develop a separate architecture